Bye bye, buddy. Good morning, everybody. It's Saturday morning, it's summertime, and it's sunrise, and we are rolling out to the spot. What's going on, guys? RDV here, bringing you another episode of Go RDV, Get Outdoors. Time now is about 6:20, and I'm just arriving to the spot. You know what they say? The early bird gets the worm, or the early fish gets the worm, whatever. Last couple of weeks I've been fishing some small rivers for some small smallies. Today I'm fishing big waters for some big bucket mouths. So let's see what we get into. It's always important to keep your hook sharp. Sticky. All right, first cast of the day. Check the drag. Good to go. Today I'm fishing one of Lake Ontario's beautiful marinas. You can find marinas like this scattered all along the shores of different cities throughout the lake. The great thing about these marinas is they've got a ton of structure where the fish can relate to. Here specifically, we've got metal retaining walls, there's a dock on the left side there, there's a ton of weeds underneath the water, and then you can also see some chunk rock there as well. With that being said, it was pretty murky, so it was tough to see what was going on underneath the water. Alright guys, we're in spot number 2. Time now is about 7:20, so it's been about an hour, no bites. I'm grinding it out. The spot here, it does look like the water is a whole lot clearer. So let's see what we can do. What I love about this spot is that there's a ton of different types of cover. If you look to the left there, there's some riprap. I'm standing on a rock retaining wall. There's a lot of lily pads, some weed growth, and then on the right side there, you can see some docks. Underneath the water as well, as there are a lot of chunky rocks. Game plan for something like this would be to dunk my bait in between the weeds and see what we could get into. I would also key into the transitions between the riprap and the weed line, as well as any open spaces where I can actually see the rocks, because that'll create some spaces where the bass would like to relate to. Once the bait is in the water, I like to either twitch it, give it a couple of hops, or whatever, just to see if we can entice a bass into striking. Fish on.
That was crazy. It jumped into the net and I got it.
Notice I don't unhook the fish. That's because when I was trying to net the fish, it actually jumped right in as the hook popped out. Crazy.
Not a bad little guy. About a 15-inch fish.
Nice.
1.9 pounds. Bye bye, buddy. That last fish, all I did was pitch to the corner here, let it sink to the bottom. Just gonna slowly drag it back. And as I kept walking all the way down through here, I caught the hit. All right, doing some more searching. The way I usually get to this area has been closed down by the city apparently. And yeah, so I'm just trying to find some new fishable spots. Not too much depth here at all. It's probably less than a foot deep. Let's see, I think I see a pike. Let's see if I can catch it. Spooked him. Yep. Fuck.
Okay.
I gotcha. Oh, this guy's a tank! This guy's a monster, holy. What's that? No. This thing's huge.
You always come
here? Every couple of weeks I come down. Two, five, eight. Not a bad one. It's a largemouth bass. Yeah. Yes, sir. All right, let's get a release on this one. Uh-huh.